Hey everybody, coming to you from our garage here, and Jordan's been out here all day spraying on the Trans Am, so I thought I'd give you an update, show you his progress so far. For those of you that have been watching the Trans Am project here, you may be aware that a few weeks back he had a little incident, and he actually knocked the front bumper cover off and busted up the ground effects and that sort of thing. So we did find a nice new bumper cover, ground effects, put some new tie rods on it. And it's all set, other than it was, you know, red, white, and black, multicolor.
Triple color.
Yeah, so Jordan couldn't handle driving it like that, so he decided to put some paint on it. What we decided to use is this rubber dip spray, you know, Plasti dip that you've probably heard a lot about lately. And it's pretty durable stuff. I mean, it's the same thing you'll find on, like, tool handles.
This is the same stuff I had on my hood for like a year through winter, and I held a pressure washer an inch away from it and it wouldn't take it off. So.
It holds up really well. What color did you use, first off?
I got 2 gallons of gunmetal gray, rubber dip S, and then I got the tint kit that they sell on their website, and I just used 3 black tints into 2 gallons. So that's about a 1.5 tints per gallon.
Okay. And then we're actually, once this is all applied, he's actually going to go over it with some glossifier, which he has in the box there. We got the air compressor outside because that thing's really noisy.
It's unbearably loud in here.
But I thought we'd give you a look at it here while it's still flat before the glossifier goes on. And you can see, I think he did a really nice job of laying it down. It's looking smooth.
I'm happy with it considering it's the first car I've ever actually sprayed myself.
He's got the door open right now because he was spraying in the door jams and that sort of thing.
Yeah, I didn't.
He just wanted it to look professional when you open the door, so it wasn't like red on the inside. He's got the door panel off right now. But as you can see, the car's looking really slick. I like that color, and I am kind of curious what it's going to do when he puts the glossifier on. Another thing, Jordan thought it would look really cool and kind of custom if he took those door moldings off. If you recall on these Trans Ams, they have like a plastic molding that goes down the side. I actually do think it looks a lot better without it.
To do that, I just I got a cheap heat gun and some fishing line. And
yeah, like a Wagner paint heat gun, and it took them right off. One of the reasons he decided to go with Plasti Dip is because there's a few things that need to be fixed on this car before it actually gets a good paint job. For one, you know, a long while back, if you recall, we hit a deer with the car, so it's still kind of rumpled up here and there. And it could probably be, obviously, we could do some body work and straighten that out, but we know we intend on putting a fiberglass cowl hood on it. So for the time being, it made a lot more sense just to do Plasti Dip.
Well, there's no point in taking it in, getting it properly painted, and then doing that knowing that I have to get the hood paint matched again in
right.
a month or so.
But this bumper cover, when we put it on, that was white, you know, obviously, because it was off a different car. And we also put new, those little lower ground effects there. But at least this way it'll be one cohesive color. And actually, I like this color a lot more than the red myself.
I wasn't sure when I was mixing the paint because it looks a little lighter in the bucket. Mm-hmm. And I'm really pleased with how it turned out. It dried pretty dark, and I think it's a pretty cool color.
This color is really cool. It's kind of like, I've seen a lot of like exotic cars in this color recently, Lamborghinis, you know, Audis, that sort of thing. So it's pretty cool. But you can see that, I mean, it's looking nice and smooth. I just wanted to show it to you before the clear went on.
One thing, if anybody's ever gonna do this, this you got to be really careful about when you open it. Make sure that you actually spray in there. You know, you do a better job about it than I did, but make sure you get this too, because when you go to open it, it'll peel it off and you'll have a red gas cap or whatever color your car is.
Right. Then he's got the spoiler out here as well. He decided for right now he did just everything basically in that charcoal gray. Then he might come back and do some black accents on the spoiler and on maybe even do a black hood again, because it does look cool. It just depends on what we think after it's done.
I haven't decided what I'm doing yet. Yeah. I just want to get the base color down and make it thick and durable first.
And don't tell me how horrible the garage looks, because it really is a mess.
that's my fault. I had to rig up some things.
Yeah. All right, guys. Well, it's getting late in the day, and he needs to get that clear on there. So I just wanted to give you a quick update, show you what he's doing. I think so far it's looking pretty darn good. So it's going to be interesting to see what it looks like with the glossifier on there. Thanks for watching and commenting and everything, and we'll see you later. Bye.